Underwriters use actuarial tables in order to check the mortality rates for various different activities when they are setting insurance premiums for life insurance policies based upon various different activities that they might consider to be risky. Owning a gun is not considered when figuring mortality for life insurance purposes, even though auto fatalities and fatal gunshot wounds typically have similar numbers, with around 34,000 people dying yearly from each. Application forms for life insurance include questions about activities that are considered particularly risky. Being a race car driver, member of a skydiving club, rock climbing club, having a private pilot's license, or being a certified scuba diver will usually flag someone and necessitate the need for higher-priced, high-risk insurance. I don't have a private pilot's license, but I did want to learn how to fly. My flight instructor crashed about 300 yards from my house into the lake that we live nearby as he was tipping his wings to say hi to somebody standing on the shore. I am a certified scuba diver, but my wife Beth Ann and I do participate in some types of what would be considered risky behavior. Here, my wife Beth Ann is ziplining over a canyon on an island off the coast of Honduras. People have died on this course.
You stop yourself on the pillow. On the pillow. Keep your feet up.
Oh, keep my feet up. I thought you said to hit it. Okay. Yeah,
keep your feet up.
Okay, I didn't hear that.
Good job. Here I'm taking a picture of Horseshoe Bend in Arizona. People have fallen to their deaths at this very spot. But whether we have been river rafting, horseback riding, hot air ballooning, mountain climbing, hiking by the Rio Grande or at Sedona, or even simply riding a train, these things may look dangerous. But we take safety precautions. We avoid being a statistic in one of those actuary tables because we go out of our way to make sure that the things that we do are reasonably safe, even though they may look like they're dangerous. The greatest danger that there is, that I can even imagine, would be going through life without believing that Jesus the Christ died on the cross for our sins and is risen from the dead. It pains me to think that anyone that I know, anyone that I have ever come in contact with, would spend eternity separated from God. Jesus died on the cross for our sins. He is risen from the dead. Faith in Him brings eternal life and salvation. If I could have just one wish, it would be for your salvation. Pray and ask Christ to come into your life. Don't let this day go by without doing it. Someday, each one of us is going to be a member of one of those groups on those actuarial tables. Hopefully, it's going to be those who died from having a very long, long life. I'm Dr. James Blanchard, and I'm all about the truth. If you've never prayed and received Jesus Christ as Savior, now's the time to do it. Just pray this prayer with me. And if you believe what you're saying with your mouth, then God will hear your cry. He'll answer your prayers. He'll forgive your sins and give you a new life. Just pray and say, Heavenly Father, thank you for Jesus. I know He died on the cross for me. I believe He came back from the dead. I pray You'd come into my life. Forgive my sins. I receive Jesus as my Savior. And I give my life to You. And thank You for saving me. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.